Yo, what's up guys, this is your sailor friend, the Merchant Lady Guy, and I have repeatedly been getting this question: how do sailors sail and still maintain a happy married life? The simple answer is that we don't. All the credit for the happy married life of a sailor goes to the wife of a sailor. So it's obvious that a sailor wife is the only person who can tell us more about the secrets of a happy married life of a sailor. And to answer all your questions, we have with us gorgeous sailor wife, Miss Priti. Thank you, Priti, for being a part of this interview. Your insights are going to help a lot of people, I'm sure. So would you please tell us something about yourself?
Hi, this is Priti. I am from Bombay and I've been married for 2.5 years. And I've been doing travel blogging from last 2 years now.
Okay.
So that's about it. And I'm here with the Merchant Navy guy, Hitesh himself.
So Priti, tell me, is your Merchant Navy guy with you right now, or is he on sailing on a ship?
No, he's sailing right now. He's supposed to be back before Diwali.
What sort of ship he is on? Do you know what type of ship he's on?
Yes, I have sailed on tanker ships. And he's sailing on tanker ships, okay. Oil tankers, well, yeah.
Product or crew?
I think product.
Okay, Priti, so why did you marry a Merchant Navy guy?
See, I did not marry a Merchant Navy guy. I married him as a person he is, and not because of the profession. We fell in love and that's how.
But did uniform play a part in all this? Was it a plus point of attraction?
Of course. I mean, yes, they look...
She just restored hope for like millions of sailors.
Of course, you guys look handsome in the uniform, but that is not the only point why I get married to him.
So it played a part in attraction?
Yes, somewhere.
Please tell us, how did you guys meet?
So we met online, and that's how it started.
There's some hope. For all of you sailors who are sailing in different countries, they met.
Social media plays a big role.
I'm happy to know that. And then?
We exchanged messages and we started talking on WhatsApp. And then we met after a month of chatting. We met.
Isn't that beautiful?
That's how it happened.
That is really. I'm sure that you've been asked this question a lot of times. How do you manage alone while you're sailing?
Yeah, managing alone for 4 months is really difficult, and it is not everyone's cup of tea. Be it paying the electricity bill, attending the family functions alone. So yeah, it gets really difficult sometimes. But it just gets into your routine and you get used to it.
Okay, so Priti, tell us, what is the biggest challenge for you while he's away?
I know this is going to be a really funny answer, but the biggest challenge for me is that I don't have anyone at home who can open the door for my maid. I am the only one.
In the morning?
Yes.
Okay.
So I have to get up 7 in the morning to open the door for my maid. So that is the biggest challenge I am facing right now.
It's an unconventional answer, but a good answer nonetheless. So will you suggest other girls to marry a Merchant Navy guy or date a sailor?
No, that's a tricky one, but yes, I would definitely recommend, if you love traveling, if you want to travel all over the world, you should marry a Merchant Navy guy.
Okay, just because of traveling.
Of course! I mean,
on behalf of all the sailor community, we thank Priti so much for supporting us.
See, I love traveling, so that was one consideration of marrying a Merchant Navy guy, that you get to travel a lot and that is for free. That is the...
So, this is the real story, that's why you married a Merchant Navy guy?
No, not really. I told you in the beginning, why did I marry a Merchant Navy guy?
What do you like the most about Merchant Navy?
So, as a sailor's wife, when you are sailing on board, you don't really have to do anything on board. You don't have to cook, you don't have to make your bed. So basically you are just chilling for 2-3 months.
It's like an onboard vacation.
Yeah, it's actually a vacation when you are on board, and I would say that only the privileged one gets to sail on the ships. So yeah, that is the coolest part.
You are getting quite emotional with this answer. Like, you love sailing? You like?
Yes,
sailing.
I love sailing.
Have you sailed with your husband ever?
Yes, I have sailed with him twice. So my total sea time is, I would say sea time, yeah.
Six months.
Yeah. So twice I've been on board. Yeah.
So they were both like same types of ships or different types of ships?
Same type.
Okay, tankers.
Yeah. He sails only on tankers.
Okay. He's a tanker man.
Yeah. So tanker man. So yeah.
So like, which was your best surely, like the place you visited and it just touched your heart while sailing?
That would be Melbourne, because Melbourne has a great shopping experience I had when I was in Melbourne.
Okay.
Yeah, shopping.
Alright, now we get it. Okay, so what's the one thing you dislike about this profession?
Okay, is that even a question? So, what I dislike is the long distance. That is the most hardest.
Totally.
And
totally, yeah.
Yeah, the most hardest part of being a sailor's wife. Plus on top of that, they don't get enough internet to chat, to call. So yeah, that is the most challenging and most difficult part.
She is like raising some social issues with this answer.
Yeah,
you don't get enough internet.
See, he gets only 350 MB a month.
Depends on the company, but it's usually yeah, very, very less.
Yeah. And before marriage, we were actually talking on the emails. We were not even on WhatsApp. So yeah, it gets really difficult sometimes.
I'm sure a lot of lovers would relate to this story, where boyfriends or girlfriends are at sea, out at sea, and the other half is at land.
Yeah, and the worst part is that you don't even call him when it's his birthday. I always wait for him to call me, and then I wish him, "Hi baby, happy birthday." So that's something there.
It's a very, very good answer and a very good social issue too. So moving on to a little emotional, little touchy topic here. How do you feel when he's about to join or when he joins a ship?
I can't really tell you, but yes, it's a mixed feeling. I feel sad. Of course I feel sad. And that I'll be seeing him after 4 months, and yes, I cry every time he goes. I cry.
So don't you think your crying makes it all the more difficult for him to join a ship?
Yes, it does. But then I cannot stop crying. I mean, I cannot stop my emotions or my feelings. But then I keep motivating myself that yes, it is his job. He has to go.
So when
it is always emotional whenever he joins the ship.
When does the crying typically start? Like 2-3 hours before joining, a day before joining, 2 days before joining? What's the time?
At least a week before joining, I cry. I keep crying. I'm packing his stuff, I'm keeping his clothes. I'm crying. Why are you going?
Okay. So she cries a lot. What's the feeling when he's about to sign off, when you come to know that he's about to sign off? Or does he surprises you? He tells you that he's about to sign off?
Yeah, he tells me. And it's actually, my excitement is on another level only when he tells me that he's signing off. And I start watching the YouTube videos about all the good recipes that I'm going to make when he's home. And I start making my shopping list for the duty free.
Okay. So, Priti, are you planning on joining your husband anytime soon on ship, on board?
I am not really sure if he wants me to join the ship this
time. Of course he wants you to join. Everybody wants their wife to join.
But yes, I would definitely like to join him again this time. So, I am planning to go on board in end of August, if everything goes fine. Or otherwise next year for sure.
Alright guys, we have reached the end of this interview. So before we leave, would you like to share some tips or some pointers to other sailor wives as to how to make their marriage happy, how to keep it intact?
Okay, so I would like to give two important points for all the sailors' wife, that be loyal to your husbands, and that is the most important point. And if you are housewives, you're not working, make sure you are keeping yourself very busy so that you don't miss your husband and you don't really get time to cry all the time. So yeah, and be supportive always when your husband is away, when your husband is on board. Be nice to him.
Thank you, PZ, for these amazing insights, and I sincerely hope that your love gets deeper and deeper with time.
Thank you for having me.
If you guys like this video, leave a like.
And don't forget to subscribe to the Merchant Navy Guy and give this video a big thumbs up, guys. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, guys. Hitesh is going to put the link in the description below. So please follow me there.